What's up, gang? We got a lot on the docket this week. We've got some state victories, a recap of our diversity assembly, and a special guest feature. Not you.
You won't want to miss it, so stick around and...
Welcome back to OETV!
We have quite a few announcements to get into, so let's get started.
First and foremost, Olathe East Swim and Dive did a phenomenal job at state. Congratulations are in order for Gavin Fregon, Kobe Otero, Elliot Bowman, and Adam Hagen for taking first place with their relay team.
All right, we were given the chance to talk to the state championship 200 freestyle relay. Let's get right into it.
Elliot, what is your pre-race ritual to get you into the mindset?
I don't really got a ritual. I just kind of put my cap and goggles on and get ready.
I like to just visualize it, think about every turn, every single stroke, and just get a clear picture of what it's going to look like in my head.
Pre-race ritual, usually behind the block, it's like pretty much tunnel vision. I look down at the other end, and I'll really focus on what I need to do during the race. And I'll slap myself a couple times, and like on the chest, and I'll get ready, get in the zone, and just focus on my swim.
I slap myself a bunch, and I just focus on what strokes I need to be swimming, so then I do it the best I can.
And winning an event at state isn't easy. You must train really hard. What do you focus on in practice to help you be successful?
I just focus on my walls every turn and try not to skip out like some other people and just put in like 100% effort.
You know, obviously going fast is a necessary component as practice, and then mainly underwaters and just whatever coach is really trying to get you to work on for your technique.
If I know what I'm racing, I'll usually focus on what I'm gonna race during that whole week of practice. Usually it's the 50 or 100, so I'll usually focus on like doing straight arm, fast kicks, fast turns in and out of the wall, underwater work, stuff like that. So it's like really focusing on pushing off the walls good and have fast turns, so yeah.
Just give like 100% and like really think about what I'm doing so then I improve.
All right. What advice would you give to other athletes who want to be as successful as you did?
Consistency is key. You gotta like go to all the morning weights. I know I didn't do that, but I definitely could have been a lot better if I did do that.
Mainly consistency. Show up every day and try your hardest and the results will come.
I would say not give up and keep pushing every day, work hard. And I mean, it doesn't come easy, you know, so it takes a lot of hard work and determination, but if you want it that bad, then you'll go get it, so.
Just work hard and surround yourself with fast people.
Great job, guys. On top of that, Charlie Matthews took home first place for his second state diving title of his high school career. Stellar job, Chuck.
Speaking of state, Wishaw Girls varsity team, along with Brylan Jones, good luck at state this Friday, where they'll be capping off an incredible season.
If you're looking for something to do with your evening, be sure to catch the improv comedy show, either tonight or Friday at 7 p.m. Hope to see you there.
And I think that's everything. Moving on to our...
I'm getting a phone call.
Oh, hold on. I think I'm getting one, too.
I think they're saying that...
Brett Carroll won state for wrestling! This past week, Brett Carroll became the first person to win the state wrestling title in Olathe East history. Amazing job, Brett.
Do you feel like you don't have enough Olathe East merchandise to celebrate all these state wins?
Well, do we have the deal for you, with a brand new drop in the Hawk's Nest. This week, the Hawk's Nest is dropping our Stronger Together shirt. These puppies will be available in all sizes, models not included. But I wish they were.
Now, with all that wrapped up, let's take a look back at some of the highlights from the outstanding diversity assembly we held last week. Take a look.
Last Thursday, Olathe East held their first ever diversity assembly.
Students represented 50 different countries. Alyssa Allmerger-Smith and Hugh Doe performed songs. The Black Student Union danced, and others shared their cultures through skits. Overall, this was a great opportunity for students to share their cultures.
What a great time!
You know what my favorite holiday is?
What is it?
Dr. Seuss Day.
Yeah.
We went around the Olathe East hallways to ask some trivia about the author. Check it out.
All right, so I'm gonna ask you 3 Dr. Seuss questions today. And if you get them right, you win a Chick-fil-A card. You know, same old, same old. What elephant hears a who?
That's that little pink elephant thing. I don't even know.
Like Horton?
Yeah. Horton. Yeah, yeah, that's right, that's right, that's right. Okay. What book by Dr. Seuss is about breakfast food?
Green Eggs and Ham.
Okay. What Dr. Seuss book has characters named Sidley, Lou, Who, and Max?
The Grinch, right? The movie?
Yeah, okay. He got him right. He got him right. First question. What is the name of the village in the Book of the Grinch?
Whoville.
Okay. That's one. What elephant hears a who?
Horton.
Okay. Finish the title. One fish, two fish.
Red fish, blue fish.
All right. He's a winner. So who we got here with us today?
Nicola.
All right, first question. Finish the title. One fish, two fish?
3 fish.
Nah, bro, that's wrong. All right, so I heard you know a lot about Dr. Seuss, is that correct?
Yeah.
What is the story about a cat and 2 children called?
The Cat in the Hat?
Yup, okay. Finish this title. One fish, two fish, red fish.
Red fish.
All right, hold on. Name 3 Dr. Seuss cartoons.
Green Eggs and Ham, Cat in the Hat. How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
Okay, all right, that's right. What Dr. Seuss book has characters named Sidney, Lou, Who, and Max?
How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
All right, correct.
Now, Hawks, let's see what you guys know. You can answer at home or in your advisories. You have 10 seconds to answer each question.
Number 1, what is Dr. Seuss's top-selling book? A, The Cat in the Hat, B, Green Eggs and Ham, C, One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue Fish, or D, The Grinch? What's it gonna be?
I have a feeling it's C.
The correct answer is B, Green Eggs and Ham. Number 2, when was Dr. Seuss born? A, 1932, B, 1899, C, 1776, or D, 1904?
Wasn't the United States a thing?
No, that was...
In 1776?
That was the 90s.
The correct answer is D, 1904.
Which actor was not in the Lorax movie? A, Zac Efron, B, Betty White, C, Jake Gyllenhaal, or D, Taylor Swift?
No way Taylor Swift and Jake Gyllenhaal were in the same movie.
Betty White's a national treasure.
Right? Betty White is a national treasure.
The correct answer was C, Jake Gyllenhaal.
We asked these questions over on our Instagram at OE Television. Here's how you all stocked up over there.
This week we want to shout out Allie Kappel for being the first one to answer the questions right. All of the questions right. Not just, like, she got all of them. It's pretty impressive.
Come on down to room 203 to pick up your very own free Chick-fil-A card.
If you want to get a free Chick-fil-A card, be sure to turn on post notifications. We post trivia questions every odd block during third hour. Last but certainly not least, we have a very important segment with one of our staff here at East.
The other day, Ben and I went down to Mr. Holmes' office so I could get to know him a little bit better, as well as the service he can provide to students here at East. Take a look.
Today we had the opportunity to talk to Mr. Holmes, our wellness advocate, and get to know him better as a resource here at Olathe East. We started by asking him what inspired him to do what he does.
For me, I was always interested in people. Like, people are interesting to me. And so I had an experience. I graduated early my senior year. And so I hooked up with a volunteer organization. And they told me after a few meetings, like, hey, like, you don't really have any skills that we can use. And I thought, that sucks. But you're probably right. Like, I can't build stuff, I can't fix stuff, I'm not good at any of that, but I'm a decent listener. And I realized, like, maybe that's a skill that I need to hone, and that's something that I've tried to do to get where I'm at now.
Of course, being a therapist for students is no easy job, but if you ever need to visit, he has a lot of credibility in the field.
Yeah, to get this job, you have to have a license to practice therapy. So I've got that, but to get that, I had to complete a master's degree in counseling. And to get that, I had to do hundreds of hours of like honing my skills and counseling people and breaking down film and like all that stuff to get better. And so for me, I think you learn pretty quick as a therapist that if you're faking it, like you're gonna suck. So you have to genuinely care and like want to listen. And for me here at East, I genuinely want to listen to our students and I care about our students and our teachers and our staff.
Sometimes we struggle to know when we need help. Even if you're uncertain, that's okay. Mr. Holmes is often available.
High school's not the easiest time for a lot of people in their life. And I think if you are going through something where, man, just all this stuff is happening, I'm overwhelmed, I can't think through, like, what are the next steps I should take? That's what I'm here for. If you go through a breakup or you've had anxiety for a while, but it is just like mounting now and really making life difficult, if you're not feeling like yourself and you know like something needs to change, then again, like that's what I'm here for.
Here's some insight on what a visit may look like.
You can check down here in the counseling office and just tell them you're here to see Mr. Holmes. And when you come back here, like my office is decorated pretty boring, so that's not gonna be exciting. But there aren't a whole lot of rules, right? You don't have to say things exactly the right way. You don't have to tell me your entire life story. It'll be two human beings like having a conversation. Only one of those human beings has like years of experience having those conversations.
It's also positive to know that Mr. Holmes loves his job and really cares.
I'm not like a nosy person, but I'm a curious person. And again, I just love hearing people's stories and learning in this job how people think and how they see the world and how they bounce back from difficult times. And I think getting to learn that stuff week in and week out and feeling like I'm doing something meaningful, and twice a month they deposit money into my bank account. Like if you can do all those things, like that's a pretty good gig.
Here's a little bit about Mr. Holmes and what led him to become the person he is.
A major part of my life was in kindergarten, my parents got divorced. And as a six-year-old, didn't see that coming. And I learned pretty quickly, like life does not always go how you think it's going to. And it's not always easy. And I think after that, I tuned into my peers and other adults like a lot more and just learning how they were feeling and what they were thinking. And loving my mom and my dad, who didn't really care for each other, helped me learn, even when people disagree, like to see where they're coming from. And I think that is a skill that I'm able to use now when a lot of parents and their teenagers like don't see eye to eye, you know, but I can get where they're coming from.
Mr. Holmes truly is a great resource for students in need. He was a pleasure to talk to, and we highly recommend you schedule time to see him.
I am not the only person in this school that can help students, but I want to be a part of that. And I want each of our students, when they're going through difficult things, working through difficult times, I don't want any of them to feel like they have to do that entirely on their own. And that's what I want to be here for, to let them know, everybody, that we have people here who want to be here and are available and able to help them through those times.
Cool. And then probably very importantly, where can people find you?
Yeah. So my office is located down here in the counseling office with the rest of the school counselors. I'm right next door to Mr. Green, the fist bump Friday guy, who like 30% of our students think that I am, I think. Not the same guy, but my office is right next to his. If you want to see me, again, you can check in at the counseling office and just let them know you'd like to see Mr. Holmes.
If you feel like you need help or even just want somebody to talk to, head down to the counseling office to see Mr. Holmes.
With that, our OETV broadcast is coming to an end.
Thank you all so much for joining us today, and we hope you have a great rest of your Thursday.
Be safe, be smart, make good decisions, and...
Thank you for watching OETV.
This is a really wholesome ending, I feel like. We really...
What if they're watching it tomorrow? Is this going out on Thursday for sure? Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, Yabrat Carol.
You gotta get in a little bit. Can you do more dancing and then...